Good morning, my dear students. Today I am going to discuss the question number first in exercise 8.2. The question is, find the area of the circle 4x square plus 4y square is equal to 9, which is interior to the parabola x square is equal to 4y. So x square is equal to 4y is one of the upward parabola, and also here is given that 4x square plus 4y square is equal to 9 is one of the circle, but this is not even standard form. To convert this circle in the standard form, we need to divide throughout this equation by 4, because the standard equation of circle is equal to x square plus y square is equal to r square. So to make the coefficient of x and y to be equal to 1, we need to divide this equation by what? 4. So divide throughout this equation by 4. We get 4x square plus 4y square divided by 3 is equal to 9 is given by 4x square divided by 4 is x square plus 4y square divided by 4 is y square is equal to 9 by 4. 9 by 4 can be written as 3 by 2 whole square, which is equal to what? 3 by 2. Therefore, x square plus y square is equal to 3 by 2 whole square is a circle whose center lies on origin and the radius of the circle is 3 by 2. Let's draw the figure. Let this be your y axis. Let this be your x axis. So x square plus y square is equal to 3 by 2 is a circle whose center is on origin and radius OP is equal to what? 3 by 2. So the point coordinates of the point is 3 by 2 comma on the x axis y coordinate is 0. You all understand. And x square is equal to 4 by 2 is upward parabola. Is one of the upward parabola. And the question is, find the area bounded by the circle, right? Interior to the parabola. This is exterior side of the parabola and interior parabola is this one. We need to find out the area of OA, B, C, this area we need to find. So for that purpose, as we know that this circle and parabola is symmetrical about x axis and y axis. So no need to find out the entire area. We just find out the area present inside the first quadrant, and that area is multiplied by 2. I hope all of you understand. To find out this required area, let's draw the perpendicular line from the point B to the x axis up to the point A. So, therefore, required area is equal to O, A, B, C, O, O, A, B, C, O, minus O, A, B, D, O, B, O. Why? Because we need to find out the area bounded by the circle and interior to the parabola. But in entire area O, A, B, C, O, the area bounded by the exterior parabola is also included. But this area is not defined. That's why I am going to subtract this area which is covered by the exterior parabola. I hope all of you understand. So for that purpose, here we can take a perpendicular strip of width dx. So for that we need to find out the limits of x. One thing is for the required area, x is varying from 0 to the point A. But what is the point A here? For that purpose we need to find out the point B. Point B is a potent pivot because B is a point of intersection of the circle and parabola. To obtain the point B, we must try to solve the given equation of circle and given equation of parabola. Point B is obtained by solving the equation 1 and equation 2. I hope all of you understand. What is the equation 1 here? So solve equation 1 and equation 2. So equation 1 implies 4x square addition by the minus 36 y square, addition of the subtraction by the 16 y, which are the factors? 18 to the 36. So 4 y square plus 18 y minus 2 y minus 9 is equals to 0. In between these two terms, we can take 2 y as a term. What is the meaning here? 2 y plus 9. Here minus 2 y minus 9. The term of it is minus 1. The remaining thing is 2 y plus 9 is equals to 0. Again, in between these two terms, 2 y plus 9 is now. The remaining term is 2 y minus 1 is equals to 0. Product of these two terms is 0. Only in case of either first term 0 or second term 0 or both the terms 0. 2 y plus 9 is equals to 0 or 2 y minus 1 is equals to 0. It means the value of y is equals to what? Minus 9 divided by 2 y is equals to minus 9, y is equals to minus 9. Here the value of 2 y is equals to 1, so y is equals to 1 by 2. But the point B is lies inside the first quadrant. Inside the first quadrant, y is positive, therefore this y is negative. When the value of y is equals to 1 by 2, what is the value of x? Substitute the value of y in equation number 2. X square is equals to 4 into the value of y is 1 by 2. 1 by 2. So x square is equals to 2, hence the value of x is equals to plus minus 2. But the point B is lies in which quadrant? First quadrant. Therefore, the value of x is 2. Therefore, the x coordinate of the point B is equal to 2, and y coordinate of the point B is 1. Hope all of you understand. Since AB is a line perpendicular from the point B to the x axis, 100% x coordinate of the point B should be equal to what? Root 2. On x axis, y coordinate is 0. So, therefore, for the required area, x is varying from 0 to 2. X is varying from what? 0 to 2. Hence, delta is equal to 2. Hence the required area is equals to. So required area is equals to. Required area is equals to. Area of AB is equals to. Area of OAB is equals to. Minus area of what? OAB. But this area is present inside the first quadrant, but we need to find out the area present inside the second quadrant also. That's why we need to multiply this area by 1. I hope all of you understand. Therefore, the required area is equal to 2 into integration from 0 to root 2, because x is varying from 0 to integration from 0 to root 2. Y of first area is covered by what? O, A, B, C, O is covered by. O, A, B, C, O is covered by the circle. Therefore, Y of circle dx minus integration from. For the second area, O, A, B, D, O, x is also varying from 0 to. Why this second area O, A, B, D, O is covered by parabola, therefore why of parabola dx. Go all of you understand. Just substitute the value of circle and why of parabola, you take it. So which is equal to required area A is equal to 2 times of integration from 0 to root 2. Why of circle? So x square plus y square is equal to 3 by 2 whole square. What is the value of y square? Y square is equal to 3 by 2 square plus x square becomes minus x square. Therefore, the value of y is equal to square root of plus minus square root of 3 by 2 whole square minus x square. What positive value of the y. So square root of what? 3 by 2 root square minus x square with respect to x dx minus integration from 0 to y of parabola. So parabola is what? X square is equal to 4y. X square is equal to 4y. The value of y is equal to this point towards the left hand side. X square to left hand. So integration from 0 to 2 to x square by 4 with respect to x dx. I hope all of you understand.
You just integrate.
This is the formula for integration of square root of x square minus x square. Compare the formula. So required area A is equal to 2 times of x by 2 into square root of a square minus x square. A square is 9 by 4 minus x square. Plus a square by 2. A square is 9 by 4. A square divided by 2, length of 1 which is equal to 9 by 8. So 9 by 8 into sine inverse of x by a. X divided by a is 3 by 2. Then 2x divided by 2. Sine inverse of 2x divided by 2. Over the limit 0 to 2. 0 to 2. Minus. Here 1 by 4 is constant. Integration of x square is x cube divided by 3 over the root of 0. I hope all of you understand. Then what? Apply upper limit minus. So area A is equal to 2 times R. Upper limit is root 2. Root 2 divided by 2. Root 2 divided by 2 into square root of 9 by 4 minus root whole square. X square means root 2 whole square. Square root square means minus 2. Plus 9 by 8 into sine inverse of 2 into x is root 2 divided by 3. Minus lower limit. Lower limit is 0. 0 by 2 is 0. 0 into anything is 0. Plus 9 by 8 into sine inverse of 2 into 0 is 0. 0 by 3 is 0, so total is sine over 0, the value of sine over 0 is 0, 0 into anything is 0. You go further, understand. Minus 1 by 4 into upper limit is root 2, so root 2 whole cube divided by 3, minus 0 cube is 0, so 0 by 3 is also 0. You go further, understand. Next is what? Which is equal to 2 times of root 2 divided by 2 into LCM is 4, 4 plus 8, 9 minus 8 is 1 divided by 4. Square root of 1 by 4 is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. Go back, understand. Plus 9 by 8 into sine inverse of 2 root 2 divided by 3 as it is. Minus 1 by 4 into root 2 cube can be written as root 2 whole square into root 2. Here square root and square get cancelled, which is equal to 2 root 2. So hence root 2 cube can be written as 2 root 2 divided by 3. I hope all of you understand. What is next? Which is equal to 2 into root 2 divided by 4. Plus 9 by 8 into sine inverse of 2 root 2 divided by 3 minus 2 1s are 2 2s are cancelled. 1 by 2 into root 2 by 3. So root 2 divided by 2 into 3 is 6. Root 2 divided by 6. I hope all of you understand. What is next? This root 2 divided by 2 divided by 4. 2 1s are 2 2s are get cancelled. Plus 9 by 8 into 1 by 2 is 9 by 4. See here, which is equal to, and you can take the LCM for example, then you have to multiply by 2. So 2 as it is, the LCM of 4 and 6 is 12. 4 and 6 LCM. 2 2s are 2 3s, 4 4 3s are 12. 12 is LCM. Here multiply by 3, here multiply by 2. So So required area is equal to, required area is equal to 3 root 2 minus root 2 is 1 root 2. That is root 2 divided by 12, as it is multiple formula. Plus 9 by 8 into sine inverse of 2 root 2 divided by 2, which is equal to, now multiply 2 is